We're enjoying the easy California vibe of our guest. He wowed viewers, Emmy nominated for his role as Ed Kemper in The Coed Killer in Mindhunter on Netflix. Now he's taken another dramatic role for a Spectrum original series. Cameron, nice to have you here. You seem like the nicest guy in the world, but you play some pretty intense characters.
Yeah, you haven't known me very long.
Right.
yeah, I do. I think for Mindhunter, at least, I was cast because of this weird juxtaposition of being creeped out by this man and intimidated by him, but for some reason feeling like you can approach him and speak to him,
right.
which is, you know, we often go with serial killers and make them very scary. Well, they're trying to be approachable. Mm-hmm. So I think it was clever casting. I was a little confused at first. As far as the one that I just finished and we just sent out, Manhunt with Richard Jewell, that was a very, very sweet man. And a kind man and a hero who was made to look like a villain. Mm. You know, he was awkward and he was strange and he lived with his mom, so it sort of fit a profile of what you'd think a bomber of the 96 Olympics might be. Mm. However, he was just genuinely a hero. He was a part-time security guard making about $8 an hour who was willing to risk his life to save others.
We're going to show a clip with you opposite Judith Light, who plays your mother. It's very intense. I mean, it's one of those things where when they say cut, I would think you'd almost have to sit down for a minute.
Yeah, I often did. Judith would rub my back, and then, you know, we'd have a smile and then get back into the serious stuff.
There it is. Serious stuff indeed. Look at this.
I am 60 years old. I worked hard all my life. Why is this happening to me, Richard? Huh? What did I do to deserve this? Look at me!
Watson's figuring it out. We will keep our heads down.
Watson doesn't know what the hell he's doing! He's a know-nothing who wants to be a fool hero and get his name in the paper like someone else I know. And how did that work out for you?
What is that supposed to mean, Mom? This is my fault!
Mm. Wow. You know what? Frank made mention of it. There was, of course, the Clint Eastwood big screen version of this Richard Jewell story. You tell me. The characters are the same, but I suspect they're different in other ways.
Well, it's sort of interesting. Paul's a friend of mine. We actually met playing the same role about 4 years ago, and then we end up playing the same role again.
Wow.
And in both cases, his performance has a brightness and a fun to it that I just saw it going another way. Typically, most actors are going to prepare for a role. Your first questions are going to be, what are these characters' strengths and what are their beliefs? With Jewell, I asked myself, what are his doubts and what are his faults? Mm. And that's because when I'd see interviews with him, I'd see this incredibly uncomfortable man. I kept thinking of a walking apology, someone who just feels like a burden just to be in a room with you. And, you know, some of us maybe dealt with that when we were kids. So it brought up stuff I remember from middle school and things like that. And I was hoping it'd be cathartic. Hasn't quite got there because it was real. This is a real person. And some of us are willing to be in front of a camera and then we go, wow, we're getting a celebrity from it. This man didn't want celebrity. He just wanted to do his job.
We should tell you that Manhunt, Deadly Games, is free on demand. It's on Spectrum now. Cameron, appreciate it coming
this morning. Thanks, Cameron.
Thank you.
Great
to meet you.
Pleasure meeting you.